Hello friends, I'm Bob. In this video, I will show you the solution to the Maclaurin series of eta power sine inverse x using the formula shown in the top right hand corner of this video. But before I do so, if you guys like the solution, help me press the thumbs up icon below this video. The top right hand corner's formula tells us that a function can be expressed as an infinite series in which my f0 is the function evaluated at x equals to 0, f'0 is the function differentiated once and evaluating x equals to 0, f'0 is the function differentiated twice and evaluating x equals to 0, and f'0 is the function differentiated 3 times and evaluating at x equals to 0. For this particular problem, we will express the Maclaurin series of e to the power sine inverse x up to and including the x cubed terms. We start off by defining what is my fx. So we let fx to be equals to e to the power sine inverse x, in which my f'x basically is just differentiating fx one time. I will get the following. I will first differentiate the power, which is sine inverse x, so this gives me 1 over the square root of 1 minus x squared e to the power sine inverse x. And next up, I will find what is my f'x. So to find my f'x, I will apply the product rule of differentiation. So I will start off with differentiating 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared. This gives me the following: negative half 1 minus x squared to the power of negative 3 over 2. And then we differentiate y is my 1 minus x squared. So this is basically just minus 2x e to the power of sine inverse x. I would keep the 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared. I would differentiate e to the power of sine inverse x as we have seen here, which is my f'x. This is just 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared e to the power sine inverse x. Next up, we simplify. We can do the cancellation like this. And 2 negative gives me a positive. For the first term itself, I simplify to the following, which is just x 1 minus x squared to the power of negative 3 over 2 e to the power sine inverse x. Whereas for the second term, I know that if I were to take 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared times 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared, so this is basically just 1 over 1 minus x squared e to the power sine inverse x. And I can also express in this particular form. My first term is just in this form, and then my second term, I just let it be like this. Next up, I will find what is my f'x. So to do so, I will apply the quotient rule of differentiation. So for the first term itself, I square the denominator, so I will get 1 minus x squared. 3 over 2 squared is just 3. And then I will bring the denominator up as numerator, keep it as it is, and I will differentiate what is my numerator. So for the numerator, it consists of two terms. One is x, the other one is e to the power sine inverse x. So I will, in this case, apply the product rule of differentiation. I get the following. I differentiate x is equals to 1, and then I keep e to the power sine inverse x. Plus, I keep x, I differentiate e to the power sine inverse x, I get 1 over the square root of 1 minus x squared e to the power sine inverse x. And since we are doing the quotient rule, the next step we are going to do is we are going to differentiate this 1 minus x squared to the power of 3 over 2. And I get the following, which is 3 over 2 1 minus x squared to the power of half. Differentiate the inside, which is negative 2x. Keep the x e to the power of sine inverse x. So this is the first term. For the second term, we will apply the quotient rule of differentiation. So we square the denominator, so that will be 1 minus x squared square, and then we bring up the denominator to the numerator. Differentiate e to the power sine inverse x is basically just 1 over the square root of 1 minus x squared e to the power of sine inverse x. Subtracting away, we differentiate 1 minus x squared, which is negative 2x, and then we keep e to the power of sine inverse x. So for the f triple prime x term, this is the formula. So for the first term is here, this whole chunk, and then for the second term is here, this whole chunk. Once we have my fx, f prime x, f double prime x, and f triple prime x, I can move on to evaluate what is my f0. F prime 0, f double prime 0, f triple prime 0. So for f0, we substitute x equals 0 into fx. So this is equals to e to the power sine inverse 0. And we know that sine inverse 0 is 0, so e to the power 0 is just 1. For f prime 0, we substitute x equals 0 into f prime x. We get this whole thing, which basically is just 1. And then so my denominator is 1. So f prime 0 is just 1. How about f double prime 0 substituting x equals 0 into f double prime x? Let's just evaluate here. We know that e to the power of sine inverse 0 is basically just 1. X is 0. So for the first term itself, is 0. Okay, because we have x here. When substituting x equals 0, the numerator becomes 0. As for the second part of f double prime x substituting x equals 0, we know that this part here is just 1. And my denominator is also 1, so we get 1. So 0 plus 1 is just 1 for f double prime 0. Last but not least, f triple prime 0 substituting x equals 0 into f triple prime x. Let's start off working at the first term. So we look at substituting x equals 0 here. So this is basically just 1. This is also 1. How about this? This is 0. Because we have an x here. So anything times x, when x equals 0 is 0. In the denominator itself, this is 1 as well. So for the first term here, this is 1. Whereas for the second term, we know the denominator is 1, and then because we have this particular x here, so this whole equation is 0. So for the first term of f triple prime 0 is just 1. So this whole bracket is just 1. As for the second term, we know that this whole part is 0 because anything times 0 is equal to 0 because x equals 0. And for the first term here, this is 1. So here the denominator is also 1. Hence we will get f triple prime 0 basically just equals to 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. So my f triple prime 0 is 2. I have found what is my f0, f prime 0, f double prime 0, f triple prime 0. I can apply the formula shown in the top right hand corner of this video to find the Maclaurin series of e to the power sine inverse x up to and including the x cubed term. We have the following, the final answer, which is e to the power sine inverse x can be approximated to be f0 is 1 plus x, f prime 0 is also 1, divided by 1 factorial plus x squared, f double prime 0 is also 1, divided by 2 factorial, plus f triple prime 0 is 2, x cubed over 3 factorial. So we know that 3 factorial is equals to 6. We lastly simplify the whole answer. We get e to the power sine inverse x, the Maclaurin series, is 1 plus x squared over 2, plus x cubed over 3. If you guys like the solution, press the thumbs icon and do consider to subscribe for more Maclaurin series problems. My name is Bob, thank you guys for your support, and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye guys.